So now we're going to discuss how you implement reduce in a serial way, sort of the traditional way that we all know and love. And so the structure of this looks a little bit like map. In both reduce and map, we loop through all of our elements, but it's different in an important way. In map, each loop iteration is independent. We can run these simultaneously and in any order we choose. In reduce, on the other hand, each iteration is dependent on the previous iteration. And here's the serial code to sum a series of elements, and this is relatively straightforward. We have a serial variable named sum. We initialize it to 0. We then loop through our set of elements, and on each iteration, add the current element to the previous sum. And so when we're done, we can return this sum variable, and we're done. So on the first iteration, we do this first add here, and we take the result on the second iteration, do a second add here. On the third iteration, we do a third add, and so on. So what's different about this than the map example is that this add operation is dependent on the previous one, whereas in map, all these things can happen in parallel and at the same time. So now let's take a little bit of a closer look at a serial reduction. We're going to take five pieces of data here, A, B, C, D, E, and reduce them using the plus operator. First, how many operations does it take to perform this serial reduction? So we can just count the operations. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 operations, that's our amount of work. The next thing we're going to do is count the number of steps it takes. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's also 4 steps. So a quiz, which of these 4 statements are true about a serial reduction code running on an input of size n, arbitrary size? First, it takes n operations. Then it takes n minus 1 operations. Or its work complexity is order of n proportional to the size of the input. Or its step complexity is order of 1, independent of the size of the input. So please check which ones are true.